The Baking with Tegan session! Hey gang, Tegan here, and I thought I always make videos that, you know, are interesting and about cool things and always like really scientific and intelligent. And I thought, you know what, there's one thing that I have a huge passion in this world for that I never really share with anybody. And I actually love to cook. Like, I love to cook anything and everything. I like to make up my own stuff all the time, and it's really fun. And I have this recipe for breakfast this morning called Dutch Babies. It's a type of pancake that is made in by the Dutch, and it's interesting and it's very simple to make, and I've never made before. And I have the recipe and I want to follow it, and I'm really excited, and I hope you are too. So hopefully we can jump into that. Okay, now the ingredients for this are very simple, like I said, and I will definitely go over them with you so you all know what's going into it. I hope you all will pay close attention, even though it's super simple. The recipe calls for 2 eggs, which I have right here. A half cup of flour, half a cup of milk, 1/4 teaspoons of salt, and 2 tablespoons of butter, and voila, there's a reason it's in there, we'll get to that. Now, when you first start making this, you make sure that you preheat your oven to 400, like I've done here, as you can tell that I've done that already. And what you're going to do is you're going to take your 2 tablespoons of butter, you're going to put it in a pie crust pan. Any pie crust pan will do. That recipe actually I have, it calls for a Pyrex. I don't use Pyrex. I like disposable. I'm pretty cool like that. Easier like that. And basically what you're going to do is you're going to put the 2 tablespoons of butter in the pan like this. And we're actually going to go ahead and open up our oven. As you can see, it's already at the 400. And we put this in here like so. And we're going to go ahead and close it back. Now what you're going to do is you're going to leave that in there for about 3 to 5 minutes, so that will actually melt, and then we get the bottom of the pan all greased up with the butter, and when I get done, I'll switch it around a little bit. So now we're going to move on to our more interesting things. Okay, welcome back everybody. As you can see that we have a bowl, awesome bowl here, and what we're going to do is it actually asks you to take the 2 eggs that you have, and it tells you to go ahead and beat them together. So I'm going to go ahead and break these off and put these in here, and get them in here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a fork. You can use any instrument you like to use to beat your eggs. I like to hand beat them myself. Many people like to use hand mixers. I don't see a point in using a hand mixer because I can do the same with my hand. That's just my point of it. Basically what I do is I make sure I break the egg. Stab the yolks first, and then I just like whip them together, and I whip them really nice. And what I do is I turn the bowl as I mix them, so I make sure I get everything. And it's just a little habit I have. I don't know why I really do it, but this is a very violent fight from your standpoint. I hope you're enjoying it. And basically, what you're doing is when you're not only beating them, but you're adding a little bit of air to them to make them a little floppy. And that's called aeration, if you didn't know that. It's a little scientific thing right there. And what you're going to look for is just a really consistent milky yellow color. And that's what happens when the yolks actually break. Or, well, an off yellow color. More like an off-kilter orange yellowish color. And then basically what you do is after you do that, we're going to go ahead and add everything to it. What I'm going to do is I'm gonna add my milk first. I like my liquids before my everything else. And the reason is that because it's easier to mix everything. It really is. Because then I don't have to fight the flour over the milk. And then it takes a little bit longer. So I add the milk. And then what you do is, best thing to do is when you add an ingredient is to mix it together. That way every time you add an ingredient, it's a lot easier. And then the flour. Now when you add the flour, you need to really make sure that you are really making sure that you get all the flour in there. Your flour will clump up on you, and that's why I have to use a fork or a spoon, because then I can go ahead and scoop the sides. If you use a hand mixer, then you have to go back with a spatula and scrape the sides off. and that just means it's more work and more utensils get dirty. I'm trying to make less dirty utensils. And really, I'm just going to go at it and make sure that I get all the clumps out. You're looking for a very, very consistent... the consistency you're looking for is a consistency of almost like a brownish-white paste. That's only the consistency we're looking for. And this is not going to mix the butter. Once you get it down to a good point, like I have it now, you're going to add the salt. And the salt, actually, what the salt does is not only adds flavor, but the salt actually adds, it breaks down a lot of the tougher elements in this to make a more consistent type meal. It does a lot. It not only adds the, so you know, I actually use all natural sea salt. I don't like iodized salt, but I use it if I have to, because beggars can't be choosers, because I'm with great dad. And basically here, I'm just mixing this all together. Okay. Now I got that like that. Now it's time to take our pan out of the oven that we put in here. And, just in time also. I got a little bit of a brown consistency to it, which I wanted. I kind of browned my butter, which is a term of what happens when you bake butter by itself. And you get a brown colorization to it. And that's what I wanted. And what I'm doing is it's a little brown on top, so I'm breaking it up a little bit. Some Dutch, actually, this recipe doesn't ask for it, but most Dutch recipes that deal with baking actually ask for brown butter, if you did not know that. I'm going to have to actually take this and heat it up just a little bit. Because what I'm going to do here actually is very simple. So. Okay, so now that I have this beat up, as you can tell, it's really consistent. It's like I basically made a pancake batter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it to what I have here, and basically I'm going to put it on here, like so. Make sure you scrape out as much as you can, kids. Okay, and now I actually had a little bit of a bad streak here. Yeah. As you can tell by looking at it that I have this brown ring on it, what I'm going to do is basically mix it all together. Doesn't really affect it at all, but it just breaks it up so I don't have that butter sitting on my side. I have it all in it because I want the butter taste in the entire meal and not in just the outside, because it'll actually bake wrong at this point. It doesn't tell you to do this, but I know for a fact that if I don't do this, it will actually bake very inconsistent because the outside will get done for the rest of it. What you really want is a thin line around it, like I have right now. A very thin line, which is what I'm looking for. And then some in the middle. And break that up a little bit. This, my brown butter is in there, if you can tell. Basically, all I'm going to do is the oven at 400, you don't touch it at all. You're going to take this, and what you're going to do is you're going to place it back on. As you can tell, I actually have the rack center in my oven. I really do like to have my rack centered in my oven. It helps with cooking a lot. And as you can tell, it's actually starting to kind of dense up a little bit. And that's because the temperature's deflecting through it all. And basically, now what we're gonna wait 25 minutes. We're gonna pull out the oven and we'll see how it is. Now it's time to pull everything out and get everything good to go and see what we've actually made and created and get it all scrum diddly up just in your face. You might be a little surprised how this dish turns out. I promise you, it turns out that way on purpose. It is actually supposed to. It can be a little overwhelming sometimes, so don't worry. So yeah. Okay. So I'm not really gonna share it until you all get to see how it happens. Okay. Pull it out. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have made a Dutch baby. As you see, the side actually does come up a little bit and makes a little hole. I really don't know why it's called a Dutch baby. It's a Dutch meal as far as I know, but it's very interesting. It's very soft. You're looking for a very fluffy texture to it. And it's actually looking really good. It's very fluff and light, like a crepe, but it's also very thick and hearty in some point. It's actually starting to slip it down a little bit. It's starting to collapse just a little bit. Not be so high. But basically, you leave it in for about 25 minutes. You look for this consistency. I left it in for 25 minutes at 400 on my oven. It worked perfectly fine. But remember, all ovens can be different depending on the maker. If you have the same model as I do, I can promise you're going to want to price out the same way. Unless it's a little bit older. This is a newer model. I think it's a 2008. But it's a good made tab. I like it. And that's basically how we had it. This is my first video of cooking. I hope you all liked it. I know some of the parts are probably a little, can't see much, but hopefully the next one will be better. Next one, we're actually going to make quiche, which is going to be fun, and you'll enjoy it. So, this was Baking with Tegan. I guess we'll call it the Baking with Tegan section. I don't know what to really call it, but I think it should have a catchy theme song. So if anybody wants to make me one, I wouldn't argue a bit. I love you guys. Bye-bye. The Baking with Tegan section. I don't know.